Welcome back to my ASMR channel and the reading of Japanese death poems written by Zen monks and haiku poets on the verge of death. Ikkyu Sojun died on the 21st day of the 11th month, 1481, at the age of 88. In all the kingdom southward, from the center of the earth, where is he who understands my Zen? Should the master Kido himself appear, he wouldn't be worth a worn-out cent. Few children in Japan grow up ignorant of Ikkyu and the stories told about him. He was a monk, an author, and a poet, and his paintings, many of birds, are quite moving. Near the end of Ikkyu's life, the emperor put him in charge of Daitokuji in Kyoto, the chief temple of Rinzai Zen. More than either his literary and artistic talents or his religious message, however, his eccentric character was what made him the most famous of Japan's Zen masters. Ikkyu treated high and low, aristocrats and peasants alike, and children loved him. He detested intellectual Zen, and it is said that he once burned all the manuscripts in his possession. He avoided neither taverns nor brothels, and he never held his tongue. The kingdom described in Ikkyu's poem is the continent southward from Mount Shumi, Sumeru, a mythical peak which, according to ancient Indian tradition, stands at the center of the world. The four kingdoms extending from the mountain's four sides are supposed to contain all of humanity. The southern continent includes India, China, and Japan, the countries where Buddha's doctrine had been spread. The question, "Where is he who understands my Zen?" is not to be taken as a boast. Where Zen ceases to be a doctrine and becomes a reality, each individual stands alone and no one can take his place. This being so, even the Chinese Zen master Kido Chigu, Shustang Chuyu, 1185-1269, whom Ikkyu considered his spiritual father, could neither add to nor detract from what Ikkyu was at that moment, an old man of 88 years about to die. Many of Ikkyu's writings deal with death. One of them ends with the following words: "And now, at the hour of my death, my bowels move, an offering raised to the Lord of Worlds." The frankness of the statement is characteristic of his style, but it ought not to be taken as profane. The image of a dying man who can no longer control his body and who defecates in his bed is no less sacred than that of a believer who brings flowers as an offering to his God. All is accepted with equanimity by the Lord of Worlds, the god Bonten, Brahmadeva. Ingo died on the 21st day of the 8th month, 1281, at the age of 72.
73 years I've drawn pure water from the fire. Now I become a tiny bug. With a touch of my body, I shatter.
Kaizen Joki died on the third day of the fourth month, 1582. In 1582, the samurai leader Oda Nobunaga captured a company of over 100 Buddhist monks who were allies of his enemy. He ordered his men to pile dry branches around the prisoners and set fire to them all. Among the monks thus burned alive was Kaizen Joki. According to one of the versions relating the last moments of this Zen master, one of his students asked him, We cannot escape the passing away of all things in this world. Where now shall we turn in our search for the everlasting? Kaizen replied, Here it is before your eyes, in this very place. The monk pressed further, What place is this before my eyes? With flames licking upward at his body, Kaizen responded, If you have vanquished your selfhood, coolness will rise even from the fire. Kasto Sodom died on the 27th day of the 6th month, 1428, at the age of 77.
A drop of water freezes instantly. My 7 years and 70, all changes at a blow. Springs of water welling from the fire.
Kaso was the teacher of Ikkyu and Yoso. His comparison of his 77-year-long life to a drop of water that freezes instantly symbolizes transience, the essence of this world of senses according to Buddhist doctrine. The blow that changes all refers to enlightenment. A thing no longer contradicts its opposite, and time and space are no longer perceived through the concepts of the ordinary mind. Life may seem to flee in a moment, but when the mind is freed of the veil of ignorance and illusion that comes between the mind and the truth, life and death are only opposite sides of the same coin, water welling from the fire. Kogaku Soko died on the 24th day of the 6th month, 1548, at the age of 84.
My final words are these. As I fall, I throw all on a high mountain peak. Lo, all creation shatters. Thus it is that I destroy Zen doctrine.
Kogetsu Sogan died on the first day of the 10th month, 1643, at the age of 70. The word katsu cannot really be translated conceptually. It is a sharp cry used by the Zen teacher and pupil at the moment of enlightenment. The cry appears in many Chinese and Japanese Zen writings and can be heard even today within monastery walls. Goho Kenichi died on the 20th day of the 10th month, 1316, at the age of 76.
To depart well seated or standing is all one. All I shall leave behind me is a heap of bones. In empty space I twist and soar, and come down with a roar of thunder to the sea.
Death in a Zen sitting position, or death standing up, was considered worthy of an enlightened person. Kokei Sochin died on the 17th day of the first month, 1597, at the age of 66.
For over 60 years, I often cried katsu to no avail, and now once more to cry katsu won't change a thing.
On the second day of the 8th month, 1596, the 65-year-old Kokei took ill. Certain he would die soon, he composed his death poem. When he had finished reciting it, he died. After 6 hours, however, he revived and began preaching to the monks who had gathered around his bed. Kokei abandoned the world for good about 5 months later. Gozan Ikkyo died on the 12th day of the second month, 1360, at the age of 77.
Empty-handed I entered the world. Barefoot I leave it. My coming, my going. Two simple happenings that got entangled.
A few days before his death, Gozan called his pupils together, ordered them to bury him without ceremony, and forbade them to hold services in his memory. He wrote this poem on the morning of his death, laid down his brush, and died sitting upright. Mumon Genzen died on the 22nd day of the third month, 1390, at the age of 68.
Life is an ever-rolling wheel, and every day is the right. Recites poems at his death, adds frost to snow. Life is like a cloud of mist emerging from a mountain cave, and death a floating moon in its celestial course. If you think too much about the meaning they may have, you'll be bound forever like an ass to a stake.
These are two separate poems. They were spoken, apparently, one after the other, just before Mumon's death. Musho Josho died on the 15th day of the fifth month, 1306, at the age of 73.
When it comes, just so. When it goes, just so.
The sources tell us that on the day of his death, Musho summoned the other monks, arranged for his burial service, and said his last words and died sitting upright. Just so, or thus, Nyoze is a cry used by the Zen master to direct his pupil's attention to things as they are, or to indicate that the student sees things clearly. Muso Soseki died on the 30th day of the ninth month, 1351, at the age of 77.
Thus have I rolled my life throughout, inside and out, reclined, upright. What is all this? A beating drum, a trumpet.
Nampo Jomyo died on the 29th day of the 12th month, 1308, at the age of 74. In 1307, exactly a year before his death, Nampo wrote,
"This year, the 29th of the 12th, no longer has a place to come to. The 29th of the 12th next year has no place to go."
These words were taken after his death as proof that Nampo knew he would die in a year. And so it was. On the 29th day of the 12th month, 1308, Nampo took up his brush, wrote the following poem, and died.
To hell with the wind, confound the rain. I recognize no stroke of lightning. A world turns on its hinge.
Rankie Doryu died in 1278 at the age of 66.
30 years and more I worked to nullify myself. Now I leap the leap of death. The ground churns up. The sky spin round.
Basho died on the 12th day of the 10th month, 1694, at the age of 51.
On a journey ill, my dream goes wandering over withered fields. Tabi ni ande, yume wa kare no kake meguru.
This is the last poem of one of the greatest haiku poets. Basho had fallen seriously ill on one of his travels. When his pupils hinted that he ought to leave a farewell poem, he replied that any of his poems could be his death poem. Nevertheless, on the 8th day of the 10th month, after gathering his pupils around his bed, he wrote this poem. He died 4 days later. Benseki died on the 15th day of the 2nd month, 1728, at the age of 80.
Child of the way, I leave at last a willow on the other shore. Tsui ni yuku, kishi yon yanagi ya, nori no jigo.
Nori no jigo, child of the way, expresses not only the dream of an 80-year-old man to renew his youth, but contains a play on words as well. In his last years, Benseki abandoned the world and became a monk, changing his name to Honi, the Chinese-derived pronunciation of the characters used to write Nori no Chigo. Honi can mean both child of the way and child of the doctrine. The willow, yanagi, common throughout Japan, is a tall tree that grows on the banks of rivers and lakes, its slender branches stretching down as thin as strings. A willow tree is often mentioned in haiku as a picture of spring, its branches covered with green and drifting in the wind. The image of a journey from one bank of a river to the other appears often in Buddhist literature as a symbol of the transition from a state of ignorance and illusion to that of enlightenment. Boke died on the 16th day of the 5th month, 1869.
Cuckoo.
Boke, Nakajima Saburosuke, fell in battle against the emperor's army in the Meiji Restoration. He was a friend of Hogyoku's and died 5 days after him, together with his own two sons. The cuckoo has a red mouth, and because of this, or perhaps because of the bird's sharp call, a popular saying has arisen that the cuckoo sings, its blood flows. Bokusui died on the 29th day of November, 1914, at the age of 40.
A parting word. The melting snow is odorless. Chisei nano, sansetsu ni kamo, nakari.
Bufu died on the 24th day of the 7th month, 1792.
Oh, I don't care where autumn clouds are drifting to. Ah, mamayo, izukue jiro to, aki no kumo.
Bunzan died on the 14th day of the 1st month, 1787.
I crossed from last year to the new. Today's the limit. Shogatsu no toshikoe kyō wo kagiri nari.
Buson died on the 25th day of the 12th month, 1783, at the age of 68. Of late the nights are dawning plum blossom white. Shiraume ni akaru yo bakari to nari ni keri. Buson was one of Japan's greatest poets. His poetry influenced modern haiku even more, perhaps, than that of Basho. The poetry of Buson, who was also a talented painter, is full of color and fine details. About a month before his death, Buson is said to have gone picking mushrooms in the hills, and on his return he fell ill. On the 24th day of the 12th month, on the evening of his death, he called his disciple Geiki, gave him a brush, and asked him to write down three poems. The image of a nightingale appears in the first two poems, and in the third, that of a plum. Both images are associated with the late winter and early spring season. Thank you for joining me for my ASMR reading of Japanese death poems written by Zen monks and haiku poets on the verge of death.